بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything He has given us. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask the Almighty to bless the entire household of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all his companions and all those through the generations who have struggled in a way that today they have protected the deen, conveyed it so it came to us. And at the same time, we ask Allah to bless every one of us and make us from amongst those who have a deep-rooted concern for the deen, so that we can learn it, preserve it, and we can convey it to the next generations. Ameen. My brothers and sisters, there is a lot that is being said regarding celebrating the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How do we celebrate the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Our celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not connected to a specific day, nor is it connected to a specific month, nor is it connected to a specific hour of the day or day of the week and so on. Rather, it is an entire lifetime. The celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout our lives. And that is the message that was brought by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It would be quite hypocritical if we led our lives in a way that was far from the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where we don't pray, where we don't worship Allah alone, where we do as we please, where we do not abstain from sin. And then comes one day in the year and we claim to be the lovers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we say it is a day to celebrate. That would be quite hypocritical, because that type of celebration generally would boil down to dancing, singing, intermingling, perhaps music, eating and drinking. And that's not what celebration is all about in Islam. True celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is when you get up for your 5 daily prayers and you make sure you fulfill them on time. You make sure you are not lazy when it comes to the ablution or the wudu that we call it. And we fulfill it in the most beautiful way. And we learn the words of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during the ablution, before and after, and how exactly he did it, and we reenact it. That's a celebration. Similarly, when we read our salah exactly the way Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam read it, and for that to happen, we would need to learn it, we would need to understand it, we would need to then put it into practice and correct it and perfect it as time passes, the more we learn. That is a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is a true celebration, really. Similarly, our celebration of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's life would be to ensure that we do not worship sticks or stones, because that was his message. We do not worship graves or other people, because that was his message. We do not worship animals or any other of the creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether they be saints in their graves or trees or people who are alive. But we believe exactly what he taught us, that there is no one who harms or benefits besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because that was his message. So what is the point of leading a life that is far from the message and then claiming that we are celebrating the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Similarly, a true celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is when we ensure that the food we eat is halal, it is pure, it is clean, and it is slaughtered in the correct manner, etc. And it is that which is acceptable from an Islamic perspective, that which was taught by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He taught us to stay away from certain things. He taught us that certain things are not supposed to be eaten, whether it is swine or dog or that which has not been sacrificed in the correct way. If we can stay away from that and we make sure that whatever we consume is 100% halal, then that is a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When our income is halal and we make sure we go out of our way to help one another and to have a pure income, even if it is little, but it is clean and pure. It is a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when we want to eat haram, we eat interest and we don't mind and we do that which is unacceptable. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, don't do this, and we do it. How then can we say we are celebrating? And this is not a celebration. Similarly, when we dress appropriately and we cover ourselves correctly, that is a celebration of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's life, because he taught us how to dress. He brought the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It would be hypocritical for us to be undressed or to be inappropriately dressed, and then we say, I am a champion and a lover of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What kind of love is that? What kind of celebration is that? So this is all hypocritical sometimes, where shaitan comes to us and make us think that we need to dance, we need to sing, we need to intermingle, we need to eat and drink, and we need to engage in all forms of partying, and that is a celebration. In Islam, that's not a celebration. That is in actual fact a hypocritical trap of the devil, where he makes you think one day and that's it. Rather, it's a lifetime. It's a celebration of an entire life. Similarly, if we are really and truly grateful of the fact that we are part and parcel of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the first things we would do to celebrate that would be to learn the revelation, to learn the Quran. That's what he brought. And he said, this is the book from Allah that he sent through me to you. Where are we? Let's be honest. Have we celebrated the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by learning how to read the Quran, by learning the meanings of the Quran, by going through the rules and regulations of the Quran, and by conveying it to our children after putting practice into it ourselves? If we have done that, yes, that is called a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If not, what is it that is a celebration? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from hypocrisy. So let's make an effort to celebrate the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by learning revelation throughout our lives. It's not just a day, it's not just one moment, it's not just one month of the year. No, but it is to learn, to put into practice, to ensure that we worship Allah as was taught by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is a celebration. If we worship Allah in our own way, I come for Salatul Isha and I want to read 5 raka'at because I say I'm celebrating by 1 raka'ah. Is that fine? No, it's not. I need to do it the way he taught it, because that is a celebration without addition, without subtraction. If I think today it's raining, so let me just read 3 raka'at, or let me just end whilst I'm in ruku'ah. I can quickly make my salam in ruku'ah because, you know, something has gone wrong that side. That is not a celebration. That is in fact foolishness. Nobody would do that, because we know that prayer has to be done the way Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught it. The same applies to all other acts of worship. This is a true celebration. When we realize that acts of worship are decided by Allah, brought to us through Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that would then definitely be a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Similarly, how many of us have actually read the entire life story of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? That would be part of the celebration of his entire life, to know what he went through, the difficulty, the turmoil, the turbulence, how he was born and how he grew up, and the people around him, and those blessed heroes and heroines who actually struggled for the deen to come to us. That is a true celebration of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's life. Because this is when we would understand and appreciate what sacrifice has been made, and we would understand the value of the message that has come to us. This is the celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Similarly, my beloved brothers and sisters, for us to pass the message on after attempting or trying our best to put into practice is part of the celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The truth is, sometimes we are not prepared to give up the sins we are engaging in, and then we claim to be celebrators. That's not correct. True celebration is if you can cut your adultery, you have celebrated the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you can cut your gambling, you have celebrated the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you can cut, for example, your alcohol and drug abuse and so on, that is a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because you are doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, when the doctor tells you to give up a habit because you might die, you give it up. That's not for the sake of Allah. That's not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's for the sake of your own health. But sometimes through the blessing of the ill health that a person has, Allah takes us out of other bad habits and then restores our health. Subhanallah. May Allah help us to eradicate our bad habits in celebration of the entire life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Like we said, it's got nothing to do with this month or this day. It's got nothing to do with a specific time. It's got to do with your entire life. It's got to do with your whole life, from the beginning to the end. When your child is born, it is a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To ask yourself, what did he, my messenger, may peace be upon him, do at the time of the birth of his own children? And we would learn about the adhan, we would learn about the tahniq, we would learn about various other things that need to be done. We would learn about so much that the child needs to be made aware of as the child grows up. That is a true celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But sometimes we are not even bothered with the lives of our own children. They grow up like wild grass, in the sense that no one has nurtured them, no one has trimmed them, no one has told them what to do. Wallahi, my brothers and sisters, if you look at the grass, that which is cut and that which is not cut, that which is trimmed and that which is not trimmed, the effort within is not that much. It requires you to just have a lawnmower and to make an effort of one afternoon. One afternoon every little while, and you find your lawn will be beautiful. And the same person with the same lawn who made no effort, it grows like wild grass. There are snakes and serpents that would actually be found in that long grass, because you and I know that we are living in the green part of Africa. Alhamdulillah. So my brothers and sisters, similarly, the celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam would be to fulfill your responsibility as an individual regarding your wife, regarding your husband, regarding your children. That's a celebration. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, the best from amongst you are those who are best to your wives. How many of us can celebrate the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by saying, I am the best to my own spouse? But nay, we want to just boil it down to one day, like a Valentine's Day, and that's an expression of love, and the rest of the year it's an expression of what? It's an expression of hypocrisy, because we don't get up for Salatul Fajr. People dance up to the morning, and then the Salatul Fajr, they are not there. They are not there for Dhuhr. They lie. To give up your lies, my brother and sister, is a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But it's not on a specific day. It's throughout your life. To give up your bad habits, your deception, to clean your heart, to remove jealousy from your heart, is a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To remove ill feeling of your brothers and sisters from your heart is actually a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To go out and help fellow brethren, human beings, Muslims, non-Muslims, whoever it may be, to go out and reach out to those who are in need is a celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's what he did. He went out and he reached out to people, he helped people, he spoke to them, he assisted them as best as he could. Where are we? What do we do? Sometimes we want to pinch from people. We want to take so much from people. We want to con people. And we claim to be the best of those who love Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Where is the love? And where is its justification? Where is it made manifest? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us an understanding. So my brothers and sisters, it is very important for us to reiterate that the celebration of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam begins by the beginning of our own lives, or with the beginning of our own lives. And at the same time, it will end when we die. And we will see the result of it when we meet with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A person would be wrong to say that I am a celebrator of the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he has not attempted to understand what hadith is all about. The speech of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his words, what were they? How did he speak? What did he say? Am I following what he said? Have I protected him, or have I protected the speech that he has delivered from addition and subtraction? Have I tried to learn what is correct and what is incorrect from what the people have said is the statement of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? If the answer is yes, then I have celebrated the life of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So celebration requires a person to lead his or her entire life in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make that easy for us, and may he make us from those who are blessed, those who are happy, those who have the solutions of the problems in our lives given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create ease for one and all. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa أنت نستغفرك.